Hi everybody, this is Oleg. Welcome to Oregon Preparedness. Typical truck stop. Lots of trucks. Not most beautiful view, but it is what it is. I have to stay here because I gotta do my restart and, you know, I can't really stay for 34 hours in the rest area. You know, I have to stay because rest areas, you're not supposed to stay more than 10 hours. Of course, I don't think anybody checks too much, but you never know. Additionally, here at the truck stop, you get store. If you want, you can shower, bathroom, everything, all the conveniences. So truck stop it is for me, you know, even though I don't like all this busyness and craziness and all these trucks around me. But unfortunately, it's not beautiful view, but the main reason for this video is not view, of course. Something I want to talk to you about. I talked about what I'm going to talk about in the past once, but I'll do it again and using some real life examples. And what I want to talk to you about today is, again, snitches. Snitches, reporters, informers, all of the above. Snitches, informers, and reporters, they always existed. They exist among us. There are lots of people who just love to report. And, you know, the system encourages you to report, you know. Some of it is good. For an example, even I agree with some of it, you know. I see on the roads signs, report drunk driving. Okay, that kind of reporting I actually like because no one should be driving, you know, intoxicated, because not only they endanger themselves, they endanger you. So, of all the reporting, this is one of few examples that I'm okay with. But in general, system teaches you to be informer and reporter. And unfortunately, there are quite a few people who just love to report stuff, you know. I'm sure all of us have come across situations in our lives when somebody reported you for some stupid crap, you know. And this is now. While it's peaceful, while it's nice, while really not much is going on as far as SHTF, you know. Yes, we've had SHTF for the past couple of years in the lightest form. But still nothing major has happened, you know. Nobody's hungry still. Nobody's without a roof unless they decide to do so on their own, like homeless, you know. I believe majority of them just choose that lifestyle, not because they just have no other way. Possibly there is few of those, but in most cases, I would say homeless that live on the street, they choose that because there is help. There is welfare, there's government help and assistance. So there is no reason to be homeless, you know, especially now during this pandemic. You can just say, I'm afraid to go to work, and, you know, you'll probably get unemployment or some kind of government assistance. Anyway, back to the informants. And basically what I'm saying is nothing major has happened. No one is hungry. There is no atomic bombs exploding. You know, everybody have roof over their shoulders, over their heads. And yet there are still plenty of informers. What do you think is going to happen when crap will hit the fan? Truly hit the fan. I can guarantee you, in all the informants and all the reporters, they're going to double or triple in quantities. There will be a lot of them. Because, number one, I'm sure the government will create more of these reporters by, you know, giving you some perks or just for pay, or paying you, straight pay you. Or maybe if there will be lack of food, they'll pay you with food, whatever. They'll find ways to reward you. And I'll give you one example, what's going on right now. I mentioned before I am watching this blogger from Italy. She is Russian and she lives in Milan, Italy, and she reports on what's going on there, you know. And so in one of her videos recently, she talked about, you know, green passes that are, you know, that are now being issued to people who, you know, who took the shot. And obviously there are always people who would fake documents, make fake documents, and there are people who will buy fake documents. I'm sure same thing going on here with certain documentation. For a certain amount of money, you can get anything, you know, all of us know that. And so there was one doctor who was actually in Italy, in, where was it? In which part of Italy? I'm sure there is many of them, but one particular one she was talking about, it was, I forgot, anyway, it doesn't matter. In some popular, in Tuscany, there we go. In Tuscany, Italy, people would come and he would obviously for a certain amount of money issue you green pass. Actual green pass was real. It was just issued to a person who did not take a jab. And so this guy, he came home and his mom, the guy was younger guy in his, I don't know, in his 20s or 30s. Well, younger by my standards. And so his mom knew about it. And guess who reported him to the police? His mother. Because she went to police and she told the story. And she says how she's afraid that now he has this green pass that is pretty much fake. The actual green pass is real, but, you know, he got it without getting jabbed. And how he's in danger in the society. His own mother reported him. Obviously, the doctor got, I don't know, arrested or fined, or they got to the doctor who was issuing these green passes. So the moral to the story is, number one, if you do something that is even slightly illegal, I would keep it to yourself. I mean, unless you trust your parents 100% or your brothers or sisters or your closest friends, that's up to you. But if you have any doubt, keep it to yourself. And as SHTF progresses, be even more so to yourself. And, you know, be careful what you say to people, because it can work against you in the places you might not expect. I doubt the guy ever thought his mother would, you know, go and turn him in, basically. Anyway, leave me a comment. Let me know what you think about it. And don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to like this video. And I will see you all in the next upload. Thanks for watching.